Morning students, in our science class, today we will start with our chapter metals and non-metals. This is our chapter 4th. As we have studied in our previous classes that there are many elements near in our surroundings and these elements have different and unique properties. Each element have its own properties and no two elements have same properties. They are different from each other. Due to these properties, we can divide all the elements into various parts. Like on the basis of their properties, we can divide broadly them into two parts, metals and non-metals. Metals and non-metals. Yes, we can divide elements broadly into two different categories, metals and non-metals. One more category is there, metalloids, having both the properties, metals and non-metals. Those elements which have both the properties, metals and non-metals, they are called as metalloids. That will be studied later on. Now we will study about metals and non-metals. As we see in our surroundings, in our book, there are a few pictures are given. This is a crown and it is very shining and this crown is made up of metal. Here we have foil paper. This is also made up of aluminium metal. This is the ring and it is shining and this is also made up of metal. And this is a graphite lead of the pencil. This is the non-metal. We can see here a few things we are having. For example, there is a, like this is a metal. You can see that metals have a shining surface. This is a copper metal. Here we are having a foil paper. This foil paper, this is made up of aluminium metal. This is made up of metal. We have many things like this is a wire and this wire is also made up of iron and this is a metal. And we have here some brass pin and this is, you must have seen it in the plugs that is used for electrical purposes, and this is also made up of metal. We can see some ornaments are there made up of iron, steel, or some gold ornaments are also, they are very shiny in appearance. And now we can, these all are metals, but we can compare them with non-metals. This is a pencil and this is the lead of the pencil. This is graphite and graphite is a non-metal. Here we are having one more thing. This is a matchstick and matchstick tip of the matchstick. This is a non-metal made up of phosphorus. You must have seen at the tips of the matchbox also, this part of the matchbox, this is also made up of phosphorus, and phosphorus is a non-metal. Now you will be easily able to differentiate between metals and non-metals that are in our surroundings. Let us read the chapter now. On the basis of their properties, elements are divided into two broad classes, metals and non-metals. Gold and aluminium are examples of metals, whereas diamond and graphite are examples of non-metals. Let us learn about the properties and the uses of metals and non-metals in this chapter. First of all, we will study about the physical properties of metals and non-metals. Physical properties means the properties which we can study only by observing the elements, and they do not involve any kind of chemical reactions. These are the properties like physical state in which they exist, their density, their luster, etc. First is physical state. All metals are solid at room temperature. Room temperature, that means the normal temperature that is in our surroundings, 20 to 23 degrees Celsius, and they are crystalline in nature. Generally, there are two states of crystalline and amorphous in which the solids exist, and the metals, they exist in crystalline nature. That means they have their fixed lattice and they have a fixed angle between their bonds. Exception is mercury. Mercury is a metal that exists in liquid state at room temperature. You must have seen mercury at the tips of the thermometer that is used to measure the temperature of our body and room temperature, etc. Almost all non-metals are solid or gases. Exception is bromine. Bromine is the only non-metal that exists in the liquid state. Second property is luster. Metals have luster. Luster means shine. That is the ability to shine and reflect light. Metals can be polished. For example, gold, silver and platinum are used for making jewelry. The metals are so shiny in nature that we use them for making jewelry. Almost all non-metals lack luster. That means they are dull in appearance and cannot be polished. But there is one more exception in non-metals, that is iodine and graphite. Graphite is a form of carbon and they are shining in nature. They show luster. Next property is hardness. Most metals are hard, but some, for example, sodium and potassium are soft. As we have studied, we see in our surroundings also that iron, aluminium, they are so hard that if we apply force of them, then even they do not break down. But there is an exception of sodium and potassium. These are metals, but they are so soft that they can be easily cut with a knife. Generally, non-metals, they are soft. But there is also one exception. Diamond is a form of carbon and it is the hardest substance known. Next property is density. Density means mass per unit volume, that how compactly the particles of a element is, how compactly they are packed. Most metals are high density. Only sodium and potassium have lesser densities than water. All other metals are denser than water. Mostly metals have density more than water. That means if we keep the metals on the surface of water, then mostly the metals will sink down. We can see an iron nail, aluminium utensil or anything made up of gold or copper, they sink down in the water. That means they have more density than water, but sodium and potassium, they have lesser densities than water. Non-metals have low densities as compared to metals. Next is color. Most metals are white or silver gray in color. As we see in our surroundings also, the aluminium, the iron, they are white or silver in nature. But there is exception, gold. Gold is yellow in color. It is very bright and lustrous. And copper is reddish brown in color. As we have seen in earlier in the beginning of the chapter, there was a copper material I have shown you that is reddish brown in color. Some non-metals are colored, whereas some are non-colored. They are colorless non-metals also. For example, bromine is brown in color and it is a liquid also, and iodine is violet, solid, white, while the nitrogen, oxygen and hydrogen also that are present in our surroundings, these are colorless gases. Now we will move to the next page, page number 62, malleability. The next property is malleability. That means the property by virtue of which metals can be beaten into thin sheets is known as malleability. Most metals can be beaten into thin sheets or foils. As we have seen, the aluminium foil and silver foils are also there that are used to decorate the sweets. Gold and silver are the most malleable metals known. Other metals that can be beaten into sheets are iron, aluminium, tin and copper. Non-metals, they are brittle. Brittle means they can be easily broken down by applying force on them. If a non-metal falls down or a force is applied on them, then they do not convert it into thin sheets, but they break down. So non-metals are brittle in nature and cannot be beaten into sheets or foils. Next property is ductility. The property by virtue of which metals can be drawn into thin wires is known as ductility. Most metals can easily be drawn into thin wires. Gold and silver are the most ductile metals known. Other metals that can be drawn into thin wires are aluminium, tungsten and copper. You must have seen aluminium and copper wires are used in our electrical fittings and electrical appliances, etc. Non-metals are brittle in nature and cannot be drawn into thin wires. We cannot convert non-metals into wires as they are brittle in nature. Next property is thermal conductivity. Metals are good conductors of heat. That is, they allow heat to pass through them. Therefore, metals are used in making heating vessels, utensils, and boilers in industries. Silver is the best conductor of heat, followed by copper. Silver is the best conductor, and the second number is copper. So, copper utensils are used at home for making food also, and aluminium utensils are there also, and some alloys mixed with other metals, they are used for making food as they are good conductors of heat. Non-metals are poor conductors of heat and are therefore used as insulators. Many non-metals are used as handles of cookers and pans. But there is exception also in case of non-metals. Diamond, which is a non-metal, it is a form of carbon. It is a good conductor of heat. Next property is electrical conductivity. Metals are good conductors of electricity. That is, they allow electric current to pass through them. Therefore, metals are widely used for making electrical wires and cables. Non-metals, they are poor conductors of electricity, but there is one exception also, graphite, which is a form of carbon, and it is a good conductor of heat as well as electricity also. That's why graphite is used in many electrical gadgets and is used in electric cell also. Next property is sonority. Sonority means to produce sound. The property by virtue of which metals can produce a ringing sound when struck with a hard object is called sonority. Usually metals are sonorous. Therefore, they are used to make objects such as bells. We have seen in our school also the bell rings, and that bell is made up of mixture of various metals, that is brass. Non-metals produce a very dull sound when struck with a hard object. So, non-metals, they do not produce sound. Now, we will study about the differences between metals and non-metals on the basis of their physical properties. Here we will metals and here we will study the non-metals. First is state. Metals are solid except mercury, which is a liquid at room temperature, but non-metals can be solid or liquid or gas. Like solid are sulfur and phosphorus, liquid is bromine, and gases are hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen. These are gaseous. Second property is luster. Luster means shine. Metals are lustrous in nature, whereas non-metals are not lustrous. They are dull in appearance, but exception are there iodine and graphite, which are lustrous. Third is hardness. Hardness, metals are very hard and strong, but non-metals are soft. But in case of metals, there is an exception. Sodium and potassium, they are soft in nature. They can be easily cut with the knife. And in case of non-metals, there is also one exception, diamond, which is the hardest substance ever known. Next is density. Metals have very high density, but non-metals have low density. Color. Mostly metals are white or silvery gray in color. Exception is gold, which is yellow in color, and copper, which is reddish brown in color. And non-metals, some are colored and some are colorless also. For example, bromine is brown in color, iodine is violet in color. But the gases in our surroundings, oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen, these all are colorless gases. Malleability. Metals can be beaten into thin sheets, so they are malleable. And non-metals, they are not malleable, but they are brittle. Next is ductility. Ductility means metals can be drawn into wires, so they are ductile in nature, whereas non-metals are not ductile as they are brittle. Conductivity, on the basis of thermal and electrical conductivity, metals are good conductors of heat as well as electricity. But non-metals, they are generally poor conductors of heat, except diamond. And electricity also, they are poor conductor of electricity except graphite. Sonority, that means property of producing sound. These metals are sonorous in nature, but the non-metals are not sonorous. They do not produce sound on striking with any hard objects. So friends, tomorrow we will study about the chemical properties of metals and non-metals. Thank you and have a nice day.